Assalamualaikum people, this is Akrams and you're watching About 1 Minute Tutorial. In today's lesson, we are going to learn how we can create the following Chesterfield effect using Maya Marsh and nCloth. Open a new scene and create a sphere. Type 0.01 in radius and 8 in subdivision height and axis. Now create a torus and type 0.01 in radius and section radius and type 8 in subdivision height and axis. Also type 0 in scale x, y and z. Now group both of those and select the group and create a mesh network. Now create a platonic solid and change its subdivision mode to triangles and subdivisions to 5. Select all the edges and create a selection set. Now select all the faces and poke them. Now select all the members of your selection set and invert your selection and make another set. Select all the faces and poke them once again. Now select the middle vertex as shown and go to select similar options. Set the tolerance to 1 and hit apply and create another set. In the end, smooth your mesh once. Now select your model and go to nCloth and create an nCloth. Select the nucleus and put the gravity to 0. And go to nCloth shape and type 1 in pressure. Now select your model and go to nCloth panel and click display input mesh. Now select the members of your selection set 2 and go to nConstrain and click transform constraint. Select your model and then go to nCloth and click display current mesh. Now click mesh node and click mesh distribute. In the distribution type, select mesh and with the help of the middle mouse button, select the third selection set and connect it with the selection set as shown and click flood mesh. Now in your mesh editor, create a color node and choose the color as you desire. In the end, hit play. Give it few seconds to settle and then select both of your model and duplicate them and move them aside. Now select the nCloth shape and type -1 in pressure. Expand the group from the outliner where we have the sphere and torus. Type 1 in torus scale and 0 in sphere scale. Reset the timeline and hit play again. In the end, select both of your model and duplicate them and move them aside. Select both of your final models and press 3 from your keyboard and delete all the extra stuff from your scene. If you want to make your spheres bigger, select your spheres and go into the component mode and select all the faces. Transform them in the Z axis as desired. Thanks for watching.